What's up, Magical Misfits? Drew here. And today we're going to do something a little different. But before that, I hope that all of you are well. Things here are really good. We just decorated for Yule the other day. I like to have my decorations out for about a month prior. So we're all getting excited and, you know, starting to feel the holiday spirit. If you hear anything in the background, as usual, it's my snorty dog. And other than that, I think we're good to proceed. So I am doing a reading, but I'm doing it a little differently than I have thus far. I haven't really talked about it, but I do channel. And there are a couple different ways that this, the sort of naturally move me in that direction. And the most prominent one is energy work. Anytime I do any kind of energy work, I very naturally start channeling guidance and information. It happens a little, obviously, when I'm reading cards. It is a conscious channeling. It's not a trance channeling. I think a lot of people do this without realizing it, but it can be, it's easily dismissed because it can be like, well, that was just a random thought, or that's my own inner chatter going on, or, you know, whatever. It's really easy to dismiss. So it's something that has to be worked on and developed. At any rate, I was sitting and I was thinking about some stuff that I'm, my own spiritual development and journey at this moment. And as I did so, I began channeling, and it just seemed like something, the way that it was coming through, it wasn't just for me, obviously. It was for whomever it was for, me and anyone else who resonates, right? So I thought, oh, I should hop on and I can share this message and pull some cards to sort of develop it further or add extra information. So I will recount the essence of the channeled message that I received. So this message is not obviously going to be for everyone. It's not going to resonate with everyone. However, it really does apply to everyone, I think. The vast majority of people walking this planet, whether or not we want to acknowledge it or not. The message is about essence, about the core of our being. When we all are born into this world, we are a pure being, as it were. And I don't mean that, I don't mean like, you know, we're not tainted. Gosh, these words are so inadequate for what I'm trying to say. It's not about, it's just about being the thing, right? Hopefully it becomes more clear exactly what I mean, if it isn't already, as I go through. The idea being, when we come in, we are authentic. We are who we are. And I mean, obviously that doesn't really shine super brightly as a baby, but even babies have different demeanors, you know, from the time they're born. But as we move through life, things happen and, you know, we experience hardships, we experience trauma, we experience disappointment, we experience things that make us feel unsafe in this world, whether that's intentional or not. And this writes upon us and we adapt. We're very adaptable. But as we do so, we kind of lose our shine a little bit. I look at it this way. I've come to see it this way. Kind of walking through the world with all the color muted. All the color in us and in our life is muted a bit. And it's just because we've turned down. We have muted it because we felt safer moving through the world that way. So, you know, we might not be as outgoing as our true nature is, because we have been hurt by people around us. And so we've retreated. For that's just one example, right? But there are many ways this can manifest. But the truth of it is, it can be very difficult. Essentially, what we're going to be getting a message about today is being our authentic self. Reclaiming who it is we are meant to be and who we came here to be. We've got the Lover. I'm always drawn to this gold bead here, this little, and even the posture of this one, like holding this and protecting it. And so I feel like, I mean, just look at the entire imagery of the card. So you have this bead, the swan is holding kind of in a protective way. And then you have these on the outside and you have this sort of like auric field happening, this energetic space that is connecting all of this in this bubble here. And this to me very, very beautifully embodies what it is we're discussing. We are more than this body that we exist in here on this earth plane. But at the core of this being is this little spark that's connected to this greater energy and essence and being. We have the healer. Real quick, there were more cards that came out and I want to check to see if they are relevant in this reading. Don't normally get three, but oh, we've got the threshold. So we've got the lover, we've got the healer, and we've got the threshold. I'm really drawn to the three heads and the three. So three is significant somehow. This is going to look different for different people. There may be three links. I have three links to one specific trauma. There may be three people whom, maybe like romantic relationships, for example, you've had three toxic romantic relationships. It could be that there are three steps that need to be taken for the healing. Three is significant. And I heard only you can heal yourself. We ultimately are the ones who heal ourselves. We can absolutely get help with that, but ultimately it's us. And then we have the threshold. We just have to take that step. We just have to commit and take a step forward. Let me see if there are any more cards in this deck, because goodness, no. I'm being called to the other archetype deck. We got teacher, light attribute, ability to communicate knowledge, experience, skill, or wisdom. Shadow attributes, manipulating or abusing students, teaching negative traits and destructive skills. Okay, so this could be interpreted in two ways as far as I'm concerned. It may be referring, you might be a teacher, like we may be the teacher. Maybe going through this whole experience, we will have little pearls of wisdom to offer those coming up behind us, absolutely. And it may also be, for some of us, it may be an indication that we need to seek that out, that we need to be looking for others whom have what we wish to attain and sort of following their lead, maybe getting some advice, being mentored. Femme fatale in reverse. Let me see. I sort of go intuitively. I don't know if I need to read it in reverse or not, but let's see. Light attributes, highlights the erotic energy of the feminine, opens the heart. Sorry, my crown chakra is going crazy. All right, opens the heart when your dependency is rejected. Shadow attributes, inappropriate use of sexuality, attachment to money and power. And it was in reverse. So there's a need to heal the feminine aspects or to reconnect with them. So this could quite literally be like, I mean, sexually speaking, or any feminine power, female power dynamic in the way that's used. And you do not have to be, you do not have to identify as a woman. We all have masculine and feminine, of course, I'm sure most of you realize, but I also feel like this may be about the feminine being, you know, receptive, being able to receive, being able to receive guidance, being able to receive love, being able to receive safety and stability. I mean, anything. It also, for some, it might be like intuitive abilities. It might be being more in touch with the emotions. This is going to look different for everyone, but there are many attributes that fall under the feminine umbrella, you know, feminine energy, feminine principles. Something in that dynamic needs to be healed to move forward. Let me see if there are any more in this deck? Any more cards in this deck? I actually feel like there are. Is it you? Orphan Child, the light attribute. Independence, based on learning to go it alone, conquering fear of surviving. Wow. Okay, I am being called out. I don't know about anybody watching, but I am. Shadow attributes. Feeling of abandonment that stifle maturation. 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 I say maturation. It sounds weird, but seeking inappropriate surrogate families. Okay. So I actually feel like this is going to have a couple, they all, again, can have multiple meanings because this is a general reading, but this could literally be, some of us may feel we have to go it alone. We do everything. Like I have to do this. I can do this. I can handle this. Or I have to do this. I have to do it on my own. No one can help me. I don't have the resources. I don't have the, you know, it, there's a couple different ways that can play out. But I also feel like this is about soul tribe. Not just about, and a seeking for the soul tribe and not always being able to find it. Like that, wow, okay. And I'm hearing, when you find it, you'll know it. Like there are a lot of people in this world that we can feel good with and that we can have a good time with and that we can connect with, but soul family is different. That it just hits different. And you know it. You know it with every fiber of your being when you're around someone who is soul tribe. And you can even more subtly tell people who are soul adjacent that you're like, I see you. We're not family, but I see you. Is there any more? Okay, there's no more in this deck. I want to pull from my astrology deck. I always like the sort of clarification it brings. Let's see. Okay, so we have two here. We have Pisces, I believe. Mutable water sign, faith, mysticism, absorption, dedication, communication, unconditional service. Okay, that, the word absorption is the one that's sticking energetically. So this is a message about taking on things that don't belong to us. Maybe some of us are empathic. Maybe some of us are just that. That feels, the empathic thing feels very true. Okay, I'm being called to talk about empath. Hold on. I absolutely believe that, like, the empath is a spiritual gift. But there's another layer of this, and it is trauma. It is childhood trauma. It is growing up. You know, everybody talks about narcissists, but it is the easiest example to give because there really are a ton of people running around with narcissistic personality disorder, undiagnosed. It is a very, very common personality disorder. And so it's one that whether we actually have personal experience of, which many of us do, we certainly, you know someone who does or have heard anecdotal, we are aware of it, of what narcissistic abuse can entail and often does entail. So a child, for example, growing up in a household with someone who is a narcissist or some other personality disorder or toxic dynamic in which the child is forced to become hypervigilant and hyper aware of everyone's emotions, particularly the narcissist, which is why I'm using this example because it's so easy, so pinpoint. Like the child has to always be anticipating what the narcissist is going to feel in any situation, and they become hypervigilant. And so they move through their whole life doing this because they've been doing it since they were born, if it's a parent, right? Or, potentially an older sibling or, a caregiver, what have you. That is another way that the empath ability is developed in an individual. And I feel like that is a strong message here. We may be empath. And yes, that is a spiritual superpower. And yes, we may have come here with that intent, but the way we developed that might have been through a toxic, abusive dynamic, and we need to heal the damage in order for that to actually be a real superpower. That's what I'm getting. Okay. And then we have the second house, and this is the house of substance. Individual value, money, talents, validation, ownership, self-esteem, and survival skills. And again, self-esteem is the one, but individual value first off. That's the message of this card. That's what they're trying to tell us right now. Coming back to who we are before all of the mess. It's easier said than done, but really just go back to your youngest memories and think about how things that happened, the things that stand out in your memory that you remember, that might be unpleasant, and remember how you felt, your experience of the world in those moments. And it's going to tell you a lot about who you actually are and how you experience the world, how you navigate the world, how you are meant to be. You know, for some people that will mean a very, very sensitive soul who, you know, is probably a highly sensitive person and is very affected and feels very deeply whatever's going on around them. For some people, this may be that we are very strong-willed. And we are stubborn, and we are a fighter. And, you know, for some other people, it may be that we aren't really that deeply affected by everything that goes on around us, that we're kind of in our own little world and that we operate in that way. And actually, any one of us is probably going to be some combination of these three examples, right? But you'll feel it when you hit that part where you're like, that's who I am. Oh, and you'll even see it. Like, you'll see that play out. Like, you can see it all through your life. The echoes of it has just been dampened a bit. Again, in self-preservation. So self-esteem is obviously very important, but that's not, it's self-acceptance, self-awareness, true self essence. Like I said, that's what we're trying to get back to. Individual value, whom we are as the one little speck, the one little piece of the puzzle. And how important that actually is to be that authentic self. That's what this, I believe, is about. Stop being who we think everybody needs us to be or who we think we should be for everybody else. And I don't just mean, I mean, obviously for the family, but like just for the world in general. Like what the, you know, what kind of person we're meant to be in our society or what have you. Are there any more cards in this deck? There just is. Show me. All right. Oops. Messing cards up. All right, we got Aquarius. I know. It's a fixed air sign. Catalyst, reformer, inventor, individuality, knowledge, humanitarian. Catalyst really stuck out. We are being called to our superpower, and our superpower is the thing that actually, like, again, it could be this empathic thing, but I think it's bigger than that, or, you know, that's only for some of us. Some of us, that's not for at all, and for some of us, it's that, and it's so much more. That's what I'm getting at. It's like, for some people, there's a catalyst coming. There's something that's going to push us over the edge. And for some of us, this is about, for a lot of us, this is about us being the catalyst. It's about us having the courage to uncover whom we really are and to be that in the world and to experience the world from that space without all the walls up and be that shining example for other people to do the same. And this might look, again, like you actually being a mentor and a teacher at some point. for other people, but it likely is just through everyday movement through the world, just being humanitarian. I felt really called to pull in this right here. I keep this on my workbench. And I had, this is the breakdown of a crystal grid I did for a circle I lead. We did a cacao ceremony, and cacao ceremony is all about like unconditional love, getting into your heart center, right? And healing with plant medicine. These are kunzite. And for me, this is like, a lot of people love rose quartz. I love kunzite. Kunzite to me is the unconditional, you know, Kuan Yin, like, tight love. And I've got these roses here. And I really felt called to pull that in. And now I know why. I also was given a channeled message last week or the week before about stepping into higher vibrations of love. And I felt called to do a reading about it, but I didn't know how to approach it. So I didn't do it. I pushed it away, but here they're like, it's a message that they want me to share. They want me to say it. Unconditional service is even on this card over here. This is about letting go of all of the BS. This is about really getting into, in order to get into the core of our being and who we truly are, we have to forgive. And we have to release. For me, this has looked like actually forgiving the world, forgiving humanity. And I'm not there, but like, I have such a hard time with the cruelties of this world. And forever and ever, amen, as long as there's been written history, we know it is this way. And I have a really hard time with it. And I hardened myself. But I have had a few good cries about the whole thing. And it just admitted to myself how angry I am and how betrayed I feel by humans, by humanity, by the cruelty of human beings in this world. Not just today, but throughout history. All of the atrocities, the horrible things we have done to one another as a species. That might look like something completely different for you. For one of my dear friends, it would look like animal cruelty. To me, that's just another branch of this, of what I'm talking about. But I really feel like I am meant to share this message about working towards stepping into unconditional love. Being able to love everyone and everything as spirit in material form. And it's easy to say, and it's easy to pretend to do, but to actually do it is very hard. At least it is for me. Because there are a lot of people in the world I don't like. I just don't like them as individuals, right? As people, like they have their own pain and their own fear. Of fear is a big one. That make them behave in ways that I don't understand, and that I either feel are wrong or I feel are painful, or, you know, what have you. And I stand in judgment, and like, it's a whole thing. If you find yourself having issues with judgment as well, I work with Egyptian deity and I call in Ma'at, but there are going to be other deity or beings, angels, what have you, that can help with judgment, that can help. I give it to Ma'at. When I feel that somebody has done something that to me is just deplorable, and I am standing in what I feel like is righteous anger and judgment of these people or this individual, I call in Ma'at and I just hand it to her, because the truth is I cannot offer retribution, certainly not divine retribution. And if divine retribution is in order, I know that Ma'at can. So it's in her hands. And honestly, more than anything, she is just relieving me of the burden of carrying that. I hope to get to a place where I don't even get to that anger and judgment, but I'm not there. It is very easy, and we can make arguments about whether it's right or wrong. But it is certainly very easy to stand in judgment of one another and to be angry. It's a lot harder to love someone, warts and all, to truly unconditionally love the world and the people in it. And that's what I mean by the world. I mean, humanity is actually quite difficult. And for some of you, you may not be called to do that for the world, but maybe for your family, maybe for, you know, the people in your community, whatever it is. There's definitely this message of pushing through the denser, heavier, for lack of a better term, lower vibrational energies and moving into a higher frequency. If for nothing else, for ourselves. That's very selfish, but when we are at our best, we are giving that to the rest of the world too. So there's no reason for us to walk around miserable, angry, and hurt all the time. That just causes more of the crap that I'm talking about. All right, let me check if there's another. Is there another? No. All right, do we have another deck? Yes, we will. We have Zebra. Let go of your fear and know that you are safe and protected at all times. And obviously, like, nothing else looks like the zebra, right? The zebra is like a unicorn, like, as far as like being unique in the animal kingdom, particularly against other horse-like animals. I don't know technical terms, but... And let go of your fear. I just feel like this is coming back to the core message of, like, coming back into the self, of rediscovering the essence of who we are. And you can just follow. Like, you are still that person. We are still who we are. It's just muted in some ways. We have dampened our light. We have hidden aspects of ourselves. We have walled up certain characteristics to an extent, and it still leaks out. It still gets out, but it's like, it's not at full force. It's not its true, authentic version. And that has purely been out of self-preservation, but we need to stop being afraid. We were powerless as a child, but as an adult, we can stand in our power and we can shine our light. And yeah, there are still going to be people who aren't going to like it, but we're not dependent on them for our happiness, for our success, we don't have to be. Not like in childhood. We don't need to live in this state of self-preservation. That's the words I'm hearing, self-preservation. We need to thrive. We need to shine. We need to excel and be the best version of ourselves. Not holding back so much. Let me see if there's another one. Got the manatee. It says accept the situation as it is rather than fighting to change it. It's about acceptance. Acceptance of the world as it is. Acceptance of your children as they are, your parents as they are, your siblings as they are. Acceptance of us as who we are. Accepting someone for who they are doesn't mean that you allow them to treat you poorly, or that you allow them to abuse you, or you negate yourself for them, that you sacrifice and that you martyr yourself for them. That's not what we're being called to do at all. Moving through the world authentically as we are, without putting up all the walls and the safeguards, does not mean that we are not safe. It does not mean that if we come into contact with someone who bring us harm, that we just allow them to do so. We take steps to mitigate that or to totally cut it out. We just don't have contact with that person, what have you. I mean, obviously there are situations, like if it's at a job, we might need to work there until we can get a better situation. But if we take the example of the highly sensitive person, the very sensitive, very empathic, very affected person, affected, easily impacted by what goes on around them. If we take that person, it means finding a way. If we are that person, we need to find a way to stand in our power. And when the ugliness comes at us, rather than cocooning, understanding that that they're hurt or they're afraid, that what is happening actually isn't about us. And we don't have to let it hurt us or take it personally. Like, we can feel, we'll still feel the feelings, right? You'll feel the pain, you'll feel their fear, you'll feel their pain, you'll feel their anger. And that's upsetting. But we can devise ways of easily letting that go. and just feeding love into any situation, starting with ourselves. You're okay. Everything is okay. You are loved. You are safe. Everything is fine. This person doesn't define you. This person doesn't, you know, they don't get to tell you who you are, how you should feel. They don't get to manipulate you. And this is all easier said than done, but it is, we are capable of doing these things if we really want to. We can, of course, continue to keep our head buried in the sand and keep all of our walls up. But something will always feel off, and there will always be a sadness, a loneliness, a feeling of being out of place, because we are not truly embracing ourselves. So how could anyone or anything else? Are there any more cards in this deck? Do we have like a final message? Oh, and I got unicorn. We got the unicorn card. So indulge your creative, imaginative, and magical side through some form of artistic expression. And maybe for you, that is exactly what that message means. For some of us, it could be literally artistic. It could just be self-expression, period. But again, this is about being who we are. This is about being authentic, being unique, embracing and expressing our true selves in everything that we do. I am actually going to pull from another deck because I want a couple messages about how to do this, what steps we can take. Parenting. There's this term, because what I heard was reparenting. There's this term, reparenting. It's probably a psychological, like, therapeutic. And you could certainly look into that, but it's like, if you have, for those of us in this group that have childhood trauma, if we are in a position to, it is about healing that ancestral wound that was passed down to us and doing a better job. If not, it is about reparenting ourselves. So that sounds really bizarre, but it is about, like, for the self dialogue, again, you could look into how this is done. But what I'm getting is, like, so when you have a thought pattern and you're talking to yourself, or there's a habit you have, you do something a certain way and you catch it and you know, you're aware of it, and you know, it's a bad thing, that is not healthy for you. Stepping back and talking to yourself as if, so one part of you is the child and one part of you is the parent, being the parent that you wish you had, that you deserved. Communication. So for some of us, this means therapy. For some of us, this might mean spiritual retreat, that sort of thing, like, you know, working with a mentor, like I said, teacher, what have you. For some of us, this is about how we talk to ourselves and talk to the world around us. For some of us, this is meditation. This is spiritual communication with the higher self and our healing team and whomever that we have around us, our ancestors. And we have love, self-love, love for the world. This, it is about being in the vibration of love. Because even when something comes up, let's say we have a trauma response. We have a trauma response in a situation, and it's one that we don't enjoy. We overreact when we are upset or angry or overwhelmed. If we feed love into the situation, into ourselves and whatever is causing it, it brings it down, right? If we are easily hurt, and, you know, we take things very personally, same thing, feeding love to ourselves, feeding love into the situation, filling our heart space with love and gratitude at any given moment is always going to bring things down and bring peace. And, you know, that can look like taking breathing exercises, visualization, counting, to kind of bring you down to a space where you can even get, because, like, it's not easy to just switch from, like, being angry to loving everything. Like, that's not how that works. at least not for most of us, right? So there can be steps that we can take, and there would be a million different, you know, I did the video with EFT the other day, tapping, like, again, just doing some deep breathing exercises. Breathe in for a count of, I don't know, I like seven. Breathe in for seven, hold for seven, breathe out for seven, hold for seven. Pick any number you like. But something that takes us out, I call them triggers, takes us out of the moment and puts us in a different mind state, and the energy follows. Where our mind leads, our energy follows. And honestly, our heart is stronger than our mind all day. Okay, I think that's it, because I think we just keep looping back. We keep getting, you know, the same message over and over again. But I just wanted a little bit of, you know, like clarification of what we could do maybe to help ourselves move through this. Again, I know this message isn't for everyone, but if it was for you and you're still here, thank you so much for hanging out. I find it really, like, it cracks me up a little bit how they give me messages that they want me to share. And I'm like, I don't feel comfortable. I don't know how to share that message. And then this is the second time this has happened where I'm like, I don't know how to do that. And like, when I start doing a reading that I think is totally unrelated, things come back up because they're like, no, you need to talk about this. So, I mean, these are things that I need to hear, but for anybody else that needs to hear them, that feels wonderful too. Clearly, there's somebody somewhere. So thank you for listening to me as I ramble on, as always. And until next time, much love and gratitude.